fate has smiled on these teams once, which team will catch your eye again in this second round matchup between the Rutgers Scarlet Knights and the Baylor Bears?
It's showtime, baby. Let's skip the intros and get this one started.
You got it, partner. So without any further delay, let's get this one started. The Bears should be able to play a lot of bodies tonight, Dick, as they're highly favored on paper. But what are the keys for them to win?
Tonight, the keys are pretty simple. First of all, the point guard has to be the floor general. It's up to him to ensure that his team executes and has efficiency on both sides of the floor. Second of all, grab the boards, baby. Make it a habit. And finally, be aggressive defensively and force the offense out of its rhythm.
All right, there you have it. Let's get to the action and see what's in store for us. Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset. Got the high pick. They still don't score. Both teams are looking to get something going here. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Way off target. On the outside, the center receives the ball. He shoots from left of the circle. He comes up empty. Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
I don't even know if you and I can find a seat in this place, Dick.
I'll tell you one thing, you get the home court advantage when you got a crowd like this. By the way, you and I have the best seat in the house.
This is the team's first trip to the free throw line. He can't get one to fall. Gets the second. Keeps the dribble as they regroup. For the bucket. And he missed. Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. The point guard handles the pass. Shoots it. Sinks it. Work it around the arc. They look to get it to the inside. Here's the offensive drop step in the low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
He shoots from the top of the circle.
Great job of running the defender into the screen for the nice J.
On the dribble, gives it up. He uses the shot fake. He goes with a baby hook. Doesn't go.
Try to go inside.
Number 15 handles the feed. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. I want to thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler. 5 second count winding down. They move it into the front court.
Look at that spacing.
Trying to feed inside. Thinks about the shot. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you gotta have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Keeps the dribble as they set it up again. Number 5 receives the pass.
Great pressure, great double team, really explosive.
Unloads. Not a great decision there to shoot the ball.
Yeah, that's horrible, Mr. Nessler. Horrible shot selection.
He blocks the shot. Here's a double team. The ball goes out of bounds. Here's a flash from the high post. 10 seconds on the clock. Off the rim and no good. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Number two fakes the shot. Dumps it in. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. Pass down low. There's a drop step, and oh, good defense.
I thought defense reacted and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step. Very slow.
Gave it up. Up fake.
Very soft defensively. No pressure on a basketball.
And with that, there's going to be some open jumpers if they don't pick up defensively. Now they work it around the perimeter. On the inside.
Double team now, bad angle.
He puts it up, way off target.
Up and inside.
For two. In and out. The defender right on his hip, and I think he's holding his ground, Dick.
Doing a great job. I tell you, doing a phenomenal job not allowing the offensive player to seal them off.
Had a momentary look from three-point land. Working it around the perimeter. He looks for three.
Another brick, baby. Building a new arena.
Spot defensively in the post, but he got the steal.
Wow, I could have made that steal. He telegraphed that. He was the Marconi guy. What a poor pass.
Here's a spin down in the low block.
I think he's got a variety of moves. He used the sky hook, the jump hook, and now the spin move to the goal. Got to think right now. Got to focus defensively.
Let's it fly.
They're trying to build an entire neighborhood with all those bricks, Brad.
They need some buckets, and they need them in a hurry. The offense gaining great post position down low.
Absolutely. Getting a good inside angle, a poor job defensively.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, how about this crowd? They're enjoying this close matchup, and there's nothing better than a close game during tournament time.
And he knocks it down.
Rob likes it too. I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
Tries for two.
Great play to take that to the basket. Man, I'm afraid to hear this crowd. If they can get a stop on this possession. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Off the mark with that shot. Number zero is being praised by the crowd. What a great reception.
He means so much to the program. He's a consistent performer and always competes at a high level.
He bombs from outside. Bounces off.
Spacing.
Goes up for two and off the mark. Dick, how's he working him defensively?
I'll tell you, he's trying to front right now. You've got three concepts. You can play halfway, you can play behind, or in front. They've decided to play in front, which means you got to get help side.
High post flashes from left of the circle. Baylor are putting together a pretty good run here.
Execution's been the key, baby.
Overplays on the pass, and he didn't get the steal.
Oh, he's humiliated. Poor job defensively. Great shot block right there. They had some good movement on the offensive side.
On the outside. Wide open for the shot. He wants a three. Off the rim and no good. number 15, is fired up and ready to go.
He may be in the zone right now, Brad.
Looking for a good shot for three.
I wish somebody would knock down a jumper. Hey, that guy had 1,400 on his board. And look at him running out there like a wacko. Oh, man. Look at that wacko.
They work it around the perimeter. Intercepted. They work it around the perimeter. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. He puts up the three ball. Got it.
Brad, if they were smart, they'd go 2-for-1.
That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
From downtown. That's an ill-advised shot. I don't think that's the guy you want shooting from the three-point line.
That shot was definitely ill-advised.
Moving it around the perimeter. He attempts the trifecta. Way off target. And now they'll bring it up.
There he is, strips the ball loose.
He throws it up from downtown. Off the rim and no good. At the half, the Scarlet Knights are trailing by 6. Dick, we've got a close one here tonight, my friend. Give us your highlight of the night so far.
Check out some of the inside play we witnessed in the first half. We saw some great baskets down low, which really opened up the outside range for both teams.
Time to get back to the court, Dick, and see how their second half plays out. Baylor is coming through big time from behind the arc, Dick.
Hey, yeah, that might be the difference playing down the stretch.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
All right, thanks, Aaron. Shoots. He gets it to go. The power forward gets the ball. And he'll kick it back outside. The power forward with the ball. For the deuce.
Look at that try.
There, that's more like my stuff.
Wow. Little Baryshnikov right there. You always were a dancer.
Both teams looking to get things going here. He puts up the tray. He nails the shot.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
And the ball goes out of bounds. Dick, you know, we always like comparing positions and specific matchups. What are your thoughts about the backcourt matchup so far?
Hey, Brad, sometimes comparisons can be misleading. If your backcourt is weaker, then you just hope to contain your opponent's guards. Keep them in check. If you have strong backcourt play, you must attack and exploit any mismatches.
That's a nice fake. Goes up for two. And he missed. On the dribble, gives it up. Here's the drop step and the low block.
Oh, he does a great job using his footwork to get over the top of the defensive player.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
They're not doing a very good job of finding the hoop tonight, Dick.
Well, they're not working the ball around. They're not finding the open man.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in. They're doing a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
He was applying great pressure defense. Went for the steal, but he wound up with a personal foul instead.
Yeah, that's what happens when the defense is too aggressive and looking for the steal.
High post flashes for the opportunity. The small forward takes the pass. Good fake.
Here he comes defensively on him on the low block.
He's trying to three-point position, trying to deny, but then he does a great job in post position of spreading his body and getting the ball.
Gave it up. From right in the circle, way off target. Looking for a good shot. Baylor are showing signs of a good run here, Dick.
They look like they put it together for a moment. Hey, let's see how long they can keep it up.
Looking for a good shot. There's a high screen. Dick, he's just taking too many bad shots.
And I don't think he's done yet, Brad.
On the dribble, gives it up. Nice shot fake. Dickey's really sticking to his man defensively down there.
I tell you, doing a great job fronting him, trying to beat him to the spot, playing in front, making him throw the lob pass over the top. If you get help, you can take that pass away.
He intercepts it. On the outside. Steals the ball. Here they come now on a turnover. Leans in. Drops the bucket despite the harm. Controlling the ball. And in and out. Picked off. Leaning in, trying to draw contact. Boy, it's all elbows and shoulders down there, and I think the defense is winning, Dick.
I tell you, doing a great job in post defense. A lot of people don't realize that is an area that has to be taught, and this kid has responded in a positive way.
Picked out of the air.
Ooh, look at the shot blocker. Got some contact. Nice hops.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open.
Knocked out of there. Blocked.
And the ball goes out of play.
The momentum is on their side. High fives, chest bumps. We're seeing it all now.
Hey, Brad, the kids are fired up and having a lot of fun.
He's got the man in the high post if he can get it there. Dickey's still applying great pressure on the dribbler. There's the pick. There's the roll. It's good. Goes out of play. Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Brad and Dick, what a turn of events down here on the sidelines. The coaches and the players, they are feeling the heat, the message from the bench, defensive stops, and do it now.
Thanks, Erin. He shoots from long range. Off the rim and no good. Great defense. Work it around the arc. The center takes the feed. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
Nice high post screen.
They run it up into transition. Here's a flash from the post up high. Will take the shot. He makes the shot. Very poor positioning on the double team there, Dick.
These kids know better. We'll see if they get it right next time down.
Dude.
think he's doing a nice job defensively fronting him.
Well, it's the key is to really beat him to the spot, get help from the help side, and really do a great job seeing ball and man.
Wow, what a super job of running his man into the screen for that sweet jumper.
Had an open guy in the post and went the other way. He shoots from the top of the key. Makes it. Had a momentary look from three-point land. Gets the ball and now faces his man down in the low block.
Oh, very aggressive player once he got up in the face-up.
Rejected out of there.
Take a look right here. There it is. Says, get it out of here. Thou shalt not enter my lane.
Got a man in high post. 10 on the shot clock. He fires away. Rims out. They've got a player spotting up on the three. He attempts the trifecta. Off the rim and no good. Those long arms trying to get in front three quarters.
I'll tell you one thing, that big guy down inside, though, is so big that really it's tough to deny him the ball.
Tries for two. What do you think, Dick?
They need a timeout here, Brad.
Baylor are on a nice little run at the moment, partner.
They have to remember solid defense leads to good offense, which is what we're seeing right now.
The ball goes out of bounds. You talk about a packed house. Look at this crowd.
I tell you, coach's dream, baby. This gives you that edge.
Number 45 makes his first appearance.
I tell you, this youngster can provide a spark on either side of the floor, Brad.
Three-pointer. He comes up empty. For two. Too much contact there and knocked him off balance a little. He puts up the tray. Questionable shot selection there.
Brad, I can guarantee you that he's not the guy they want shooting the ball.
Tries for two. Rims out. Jumps into the defender. Looks like we're ready to step back out onto the court. Fans are pleased now, given the fact that this game is really out of reach.
That's what the fans came to see. Their team win. 5 points, 10 points, 20 points, it doesn't matter.
Tremendous defensive effort, and that forces a five-second violation. Wow, Dick, let's check out that State Farm drive of the game.
Hey, what a great move, Brad. He was able to find an opening and finish at the basket. That's a great finish. Highlight material, baby.
The center gets the pass.
Look at that spacing.
Number three is charged with the foul. Second personal foul. Now they work it around the perimeter. Got the shot if he wants it. Moving it around the perimeter. Pump fakes. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
Turnaround jumper off the rim and no good. Shot clock is dead. Had him in the post and didn't pass it in. Reverses it. I'm not sure that's who you want shooting the three.
I don't think the coach wants him taking that shot.
They work the perimeter. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Well, Dick, sometimes statistics lie, but in this tournament game, I don't think they do. The better team won, and they're going up.
Well, I tell you, won this game, Brad, and you look at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
The Bears graduates to the Sweet 16 now with two big wins in the first round.
Let me tell you, the coach has really lit a fire under the bellies of his players. Their opponents better come to play in the third round, because these kids will be ready.
Brad Nessler saying so long for my partners Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. Thanks for joining us.